Varicose vein surgery used to have a bad reputation. How many times have you heard, "Don't bother having your veins treated, they'll only come back"? Well, this bad press was justified because varicose vein stripping is associated with a high recurrence rate. Here's why, and here's what you can do about it. When varicose veins are surgically tied, cut and stripped, there are raw living ends. These ends naturally want to regrow and rejoin. This is normal and part of the healing process after surgical stripping. In fact, in some people with good healing powers, the veins regrow and rejoin over long distances, and this process is called neovascularisation. With the availability of non-invasive duplex ultrasound scans, we now know that neovascularisation is the number one reason why veins grow back or recur after surgical stripping. So what can you do? Well, the main thing is to avoid surgical stripping and ask for an endothermal treatment such as endovenous laser or endovenous radiofrequency. These are performed from inside the vein through small little needle pricks under local anaesthetic. Through these needle pricks, fine catheters measuring less than 2 or 3 millimetres are placed inside the unhealthy varicose veins, which are then heated to a temperature at which they're cauterised, closed off, and then they are sterilised so that there are no living cells and no raw ends to regrow. The vein is absorbed over time and disappears after endovenous thermal treatments, so that the healing process works with the treatment rather than against it. And as far as we know, neovascularisation, the number one cause of recurrence after surgical stripping, doesn't occur after radiofrequency or endovenous laser. I hope you have found that interesting. Do please remember to subscribe. That way you will be the first to see my next video. My name is Dr. Haroon Gadraj. Thank you for watching.